In this video, I'm going to explain myofascial connection on sacrum. There are basically two myofascial connection pathways on sacrum. In first part, I'm going to explain myofascial connection from hamstring, ligament, sacrum, and up to erector spines. It's kind of a backside connection. Okay, let me explain that. So again, sacrum is right here, and there is hamstrings right here. Then this is origin of hamstring. You know what this is? This is ischial tuberosity. Ischial tuberosity. Then there is ligament attaching on ischial tuberosity. What is this ligament? This is sacrotuberous ligament. Sacrotuberous ligament. So, fascia of hamstrings and the kind of a fascia of sacrotuberous ligament continues like this. Of course, hamstrings and sacrotuberous ligament are different structure. However, if you follow fascial connection, it is one continuous structure. Okay? And sacrotuberous ligament attaches on sacrum. Again, when you follow myofascial connection, it can go up to erector spines. You know, erector spines attaches on sacrum. You see this connection? From hamstrings that originates from ischial tuberosity. There is sacrotuberous ligament. Of course, sacrotuberous ligament attaches on sacrum. Then if you follow myofascial connection, that can go to erector spines right here. So sacrum is important key for lower part of body and trunk connection. It's like this way. So either hamstrings or sacrotuberous ligament, erector spines gets tight. Even one place tightness can affect this myofascial connection. This is very, very important. And sacrum is one key point for this myofascial connection. Okay? Now let's move on to next part. Now, next connection is with gluteus maximus and other side of latissimus dorsi. Okay, let's look at gluteus maximus. That's here, this very, very big muscle. Look at direction of fiber of gluteus maximus. It runs like this, okay? Direction of fiber is kind of a diagonal, this way. And gluteus maximus attaches on sacrum. Okay? If you follow myofascial connection, that can go to this way. And think about direction of latissimus dorsi. Let's check on right side. Latissimus dorsi runs like this. This is right side latissimus dorsi. However, I'm talking about left side of latissimus dorsi. What is direction of left side latissimus dorsi? It's going this way, right? It's going this way. So that means right side gluteus maximus and left side latissimus dorsi, these fibers, direction of these fibers kind of match, correct? Right side gluteus maximus, left side latissimus dorsi. This direction of fiber, myofascial connection matches. That said, of course, left side gluteus maximus and right side latissimus dorsi kind of matches. Okay, and there is very important myofascia, this area. You see this white color? This is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. This fascia is very, very thick, okay, on back side of body. So gluteus maximus and latissimus dorsi connection is via thoracolumbar fascia. That means flexibility of thoracolumbar fascia is very important for this diagonal myofascial connection. Why is this place so important? Why is gluteus maximus and latissimus dorsi are so important? Two of these muscles are very strong joint extensor. Think about gluteus maximus. This is strong hip joint extensor. Think about latissimus dorsi. This is strong shoulder extensor. You know, if either gluteus maximus or latissimus dorsi gets tight, that affects movement of hip joint and shoulder joint. That makes sense, right? Then what if thoracolumbar fascia gets tight? That can inhibit both latissimus dorsi and gluteus maximus. That's why this place is so, so important. If you are interested in more about myofascial connection, you can look up anatomy trains. Anatomy train. You can look up this book so you can find more myofascial connection in body. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.